Today's video is going to be about kombucha production. Kombucha is something I've recently got fascinated with, all because of the microbiotic properties of it and all the health benefits of it. This is actually my second video of making kombucha. First time I did it, I made it from scratch. I made it from like a jar of kombucha that I bought at the store for $4.99. And what I did was I brewed the tea and everything, followed the instructions, took the batch of tea I made, took the container of kombucha, poured it inside, which already had like a little jellyfish looking scoby inside of it. And it turned into this. This is my finished batch right here. This is the new scoby that was created as a result of just using plain old kombucha from the store. It was refrigerated and everything. And it was by a company called Ancient Awakenings. I wanted to give them proper recognition. The label's kind of jacked up now because it got kind of wet. So it's Ancient Awakenings, and their website is www.ancientawakenings.net. Nothing tricky about the spelling. It's all one word, ancientawakenings.net. So anyway, we're going to talk about how to make one from scratch, as well as how to use, what to do once you have one. So what I started off with was I started off with some boiling water. I'm going to create a concentrated form of tea, of brewed tea, which is a smart way to go, a less amount of it. It doesn't need a bunch of water. Let's talk about a list of ingredients. Basically, my list of ingredients was a cup of sugar. And I'm using pure cane sugar. It doesn't matter, white, refined, and rich sugar. It doesn't matter. Some things you don't want to use is stevia or any other artificial sugars. Everything, all your utensils are supposed to be clean. Hands and everything are supposed to be cleaned off. But you don't want to use antibacterial soap. You just want to use hot water. Okay? Because antibacteria defeats the purpose. Because you want the bacteria in your scoby. That's the benefit of it. So anyway, that hot sugar, I'm going to be using some apple cider vinegar, Bragg's. Here you'll see I have three different teas I'm using. This last batch here is made up of jasmine tea. I use jasmine tea. I use oolong tea, and I use lotus tea. Today I'm going to do something different because I learned a little bit more since the last time. I'm definitely going to use one black tea bag. I don't like teas in bags anymore, but I just like to have this laying around because I also make homemade wines, which is why this process completely makes sense to me. And I totally understand every step of the process because I brew my own homemade wine. We're going to need the tannins from the black tea. I'm going to use some gunpowder green tea, you know, special gunpowder is what it's called. Once again, I'm going to use some lotus tea, and then finally oolong tea. All of these are loose teas, by the way. These here, all three of these are loose teas. Loose teas are a better quality tea. Now, the stuff you get in the tea bags, that stuff that they have laying around on the shelf or on the tables, when after they're done with chopping up and drying the loose tea, which is a better quality. So what you get are basically the leftovers, factory dust, sawdust, all that kind of stuff. The tea bags work. I just prefer to use loose tea. Okay, so first step was I put the water in, as I told you. Then I boiled it for about 10 minutes. I want to boil it for 10 minutes to get rid of some of the impurities. Okay. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to pour the sugar. Oh, I'll say it again. I can't emphasize this enough because this can kill your culture, and you got to operate in a sanitized environment. All utensils have to be sanitized. Now, when I say sanitized, I'm not talking about bleaching them. I'm not talking about using different solutions because that could affect the outcome of your kombucha brew. Now, what you want to do is basically, it was recommended to me to use hot water, very hot water, for a long period of time to make sure that all the organisms that could hinder the kombucha production would be destroyed. Use a wooden spoon, don't use a glass spoon, use a metal spoon. Okay, so I'm just going to stir this around, get this to dissolve. Okay, now what you're going to need to do is the equivalent of 15 tea bags need to go into this brew or this base. In your regular size tea bag is about a teaspoon of tea. So what I will do is use my teaspoon to measure out five teaspoons of pea.
I'm gonna throw this one in there.
Okay, I kind of busted earlier, but it doesn't matter. Because these loose teeth, I'm gonna have to straighten it anyway. So, I'm gonna throw this black tea bag all the way in there. Then you'll be able to see how it gets. Five teaspoons of this loose tea. This is what it looks like. The loose tea. This is the gunpowder. That's one. Two. Three. You know what? I'll use four of this one and five of the others. I have less of this one, so I'll just use four of that one right there. Next is the lotus tea. Five teaspoons of that. And I'm going to put heaping teaspoons. I don't care. You know, the stronger the better for me. I want as much of the health properties as I can get from it. How many is that? Three?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Now this is going to be four. And this is going to be five. All right, now,
oolong tea.
Do the same thing. Get five out of here. One. Two. Four, five. Okay. And now what I'll do is I'll just stir, make sure they all become submerged inside the water here. And what they're going to do is over a period of time they're going to expand. You know, some you see some kombucha videos say leave it in for 10 minutes, leave it in for 15 minutes. Me, I prefer to leave it in for about maybe an hour. If not two. Now this batch here, I let the tea brew for 2 days. And I was concerned that it wasn't going to work, but it actually did. I'm just going to let that sit. You probably let it sit for maybe an hour. I don't know. Maybe I'll do the exact opposite of what I did last time. Because the last time I let it stay in there for like days. This time I might go with the short version. But in the meantime, what I want to do, bring out this bowl. Now this bowl, I'm sanitize this too. I can sit this